About 10 days after the PTO championship in Daytona, I'm back home here in Boulder, snowy Boulder, coming off a week of absolutely no training. I try to do that every year. I think this is actually the first time in my entire professional career where I've actually done a week of no training at all. It's harder than you think for us. But yeah, got through that. I'm starting to get back into a little bit of light exercise here and there. And this last 10 days or so has been a lot of self-reflection, a lot of thought about the race in Daytona, a lot of thought about the year as a whole. And I want to just come on here and initiate the series that we're gonna be doing, which is gonna be three videos. I want to come on today and talk about some of the things that were really positive throughout 2020, some of the highlights that I'm gonna look back on. And then in another video, we're gonna talk about the things that weren't as successful and some things that probably need some improvement for the future. And then the third video is gonna be sort of the plan for 2021 and the actionable steps I'm gonna be taking to become a better and more successful athlete. So first up here is going to be just talking about some of the successes and things that I was really proud of for 2020. I think in a year that was unlike any other, something that was so weird and so unpredictable, so many seemingly ever-changing pivots that we all had to make throughout the season, I feel like I really kept my head up and tried to just always look for what was the next thing that I could do to improve, what was the next fun thing to look after. And so I think the first of the three things that I look back on with the most fondness would be the beginnings of my relationship with my cycling coach, Matt Bottrell, in conjunction with my triathlon coach, Julie Dibbins. I think working with Matt was a massive step for me in where I need to go as a pro and trying to take my racing to the absolute next level. And I think you're seeing at these races, particularly one like Daytona, it comes down to the bike. And even the races that I did get to do this year where I was successful, those races were successful because I was having a good time on the bike. And so, yeah, working with Matt, we began our journey in February where I went to Manchester with him and we sat down in person, we worked on my bike fit, we went to the wind tunnel, we spoke about what I need to do in my training to be better. And yeah, we formulated this relationship and sort of this year was about setting the tone for where we want to go moving forward. And I've been in this game long enough to know that the changes that you're gonna make don't come The results don't come in the first year. The results don't sometimes come in the first year and a half. It takes a year to 2 years in order to have all the work that you're putting in sort of pay dividends later on. So this year was really positive because I did so much with Matt, working on my position, working on my equipment choices, and just training really hard on the bike. So I don't think that we've seen the results of that just yet, but I'm really happy that we planted the seed for what I think is to come on the bike in the coming season. So that was definitely a big positive for me in terms of starting to work with Matt. Next thing was, like I said, making the most out of every opportunity that I could this year. And I think this season offered up a chance for me to do things that I wouldn't do normally in a year. I think typically you have the preseason build and then you've got the race, recover, repeat cycle just continuously happening. There's no chance to do anything out of the box. There's no chance to really do anything that's, I would call, quote unquote, fun, although this is fun for me in sort of whatever capacity it is. This year I was able to come up with some stuff that was totally out of the box. I think one of those that I look back on was I did a 2-month 5K project where I was obviously still cycling and at the time not swimming very much, but I was really focusing on my run and trying to get my run, my 5K speed, something that I haven't focused on since high school, up there. And I was able to go out on the track and run an all out 5K with a lot of my friends out there watching me because I knew how much I put into that project. And it was all just about fun. It was taking me back to a place that I hadn't been in 10 years. And then another one would be the 1,000K bike week that I did with the JD crew where we rode throughout the mountains. We rode 40 hours in 1 week, all throughout the front range. And so that was an amazing experience, not only to bond with some of my training partners, but also to just experience Colorado in the summer. And I think you never get the opportunity to do that in a normal year. Another opportunity that I had was to go down to Durango with Tim O'Donnell and Miranda Carfrey, my wife Jeannie, and our good buddy Kenny. And yeah, we went down there, we filmed, we rode, we drank wine. I think very rarely do you sort of have that balance where you can train super hard and also kind of kick back at the end of the day and relax and have a glass of wine and play some board games and stuff like that. So just a very unique and fun training camp that I got a lot out of, I think mentally and physically. So those were all just sort of training experiences that I'm gonna remember forever, despite I think I missed the races, of course, but those definitely made up for it in a very positive way. And I think the last piece that I look back on really fondly through 2020 was my ability to race. I'm very grateful for that. I'm very grateful for the PTO, because without them, there would have been no races this year. I won a race in 2020. I think I don't want to forget that. That was arguably my best race ever. I had probably the best swim bike run combination I've ever had. I won the race on the bike, which for me is a massive step. By no means do I think that that race is my ultimate potential, but definitely my best race in a long time. So really happy with how that race in Huntington went. Super successful day for me. And I think my evolution moving forward is just figuring out how to recreate the build up to that, recreate my mindset, and then also how I felt on the day. So that was awesome. And then from there, I think that sort of put my name on the map to prove to the PTO and prove to the triathlon world that I deserved a spot in Daytona. And I think, you know, right now, like I said, we're 10 days out from Daytona. Some of the emotions from that race are still a bit raw, but I'm trying to remind myself that my ultimate objective was to qualify for the event. And I did that. I put myself out there. I raced every PTO opportunity that was available, potentially at my detriment when it came to something like Daytona, but it wasn't, I think I had in Daytona, I had forgotten that I just was proud to be there. And now that's something I'm realizing. And I think I'm so grateful for the type of race that I had there, because it's going to be such a stepping stone for me moving forward. It was so critical for the development of my career. And I learned so much about the race, about myself, about what you need to do in order to prepare for a world championship event. I hadn't done one in years. And so it was just so important for me to be there. And I'm almost glad I didn't have an awesome race, because that would have potentially been a little bit, okay with where I'm at and maybe just trudged along at the same pace. But now I have vigor, I have focus. I know what I need to work on. I know what I need to do to get better, and I'm more motivated than ever to do so. So those are some of the things that I really enjoyed through 2020. I know it was a challenging year for everyone across the board. I hope you made the best of it. And just tried to have a good time with it. So stick around for the next two videos. We're gonna be diving into some of the things that didn't go quite as well, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Millie's here too.
Like this comment, comment below too.
Like, comment, subscribe.
Let us know what you want to hear from us.
We got Jeannie, she's coming into the YouTube. What do you guys think?
I think Mildog's coming into the YouTube.
If this thing gets likes and comments, Jeannie and Millie will be in more videos. All right, peace guys, thank you.